Mr. Chairman, the last time we sat down to mark up the Pro Codes Act, I said that this bill is sensible bipartisan legislation that strikes a balance between copyright protection and public access to information. My opinion has not changed. This legislation would allow standards developing organizations, or SDOs, to retain their copyrights when their standards are incorporated by reference into the law, so long as they make a copy available online at no cost. It continues to be a reasonable approach to a clear uncertainty in the law, and I intend to vote yes when the roll is called. But in the intervening months since we began consideration of this legislation, we missed many opportunities to strengthen the bill through a better process. It was obvious at the time that the bill had not gone through regular order, which would have enabled members to hear from stakeholders with various viewpoints, to make any necessary refinements, and to convince more of our colleagues that this bill is the right path forward. Instead, we charged right into a markup, and we were unable to complete consideration. That was 9 months ago. 9 months in which we could have held hearings, brought in experts, and considered the right legislative balance to striking the bill before it heads to the floor. But none of that occurred, and now we are right back where we started, hoping for a different result. There is a benefit to regular order. I know that some of my colleagues on both sides of the aisle disagree on principle with this approach to allowing SDOs to retain their copyright. I respect their opinion, and if we had held a hearing on this issue, this markup would not be their only chance to argue their cause. I'm also well aware that there are some within the standard-setting community who would prefer a different legislative approach to protecting intellectual property rights. Formal engagement on this issue by the committee could have led to a stronger bill supported by more SDOs. If there was a compromise to be had, we would not know, because unfortunately, we were not given the opportunity to find out. Be that as it may, I still believe that this legislation would improve our laws by protecting SDOs' intellectual property rights while ensuring that Americans have access to the laws that bind them. SDOs are organizations that develop and publish standards to govern certain highly technical industries. These best practices govern everything from consumer safety and household utility installation to home electrical wiring and plumbing planning. SDOs make sure that your house won't catch on fire, your plumbing is up to code, your water boiler is installed correctly, and everything in between. You rely on your local contractor, and your contractor relies on their SDO standards. State and local legislatures, which generally do not have the requisite experts on staff to write highly technical standards, often choose to incorporate SDO-developed standards by reference into the law. In this way, legislators can key their state's laws to codes that are regularly updated as mistakes are fixed, new methods are developed, and technological advancements are incorporated into best practices. These codes do not suddenly exist out of nowhere. They are not simply auto-generated by AI. When SDOs bring their technical experts together to set basic rules of the road for their industries, these model codes are the final product. With this rigorous development and dedication to constant improvement, it is no wonder that states and localities want to adopt these codes by reference into law. However, this practice exists at the crux of a dilemma in American intellectual property law today. On one hand, everyone typically benefits when local, state, or federal legislatures adopt content developed by SDOs into their laws. The laws benefit from dynamic safety codes created by experts in their fields, and SDOs in turn benefit from more customers for their published works. If the copyright to that material were taken away, the incentives for the SDOs would disappear, and the mutually beneficial relationship would no longer exist. On the other hand, Americans also have an essential interest in knowing that they can access the laws that govern them. Because of this principle, once a code is enacted into law, Americans must have access to this information. Because if you can't find the code, you don't know how it will affect you. The Pro Codes Act seeks to find the middle ground between these two competing interests. This legislation would allow SDOs to retain their copyrights when their standards are incorporated by reference into the law, so long as they make a copy available online at no cost. Under the bill, SDOs could still put their code in a book or an easy-to-use app and sell those products to their members and related companies. This would ensure that it is still financially viable to continue to innovate and to update and develop these codes. But at the same time, The standards would have to be made available online for all the world to see. There could be print controls and copy controls, but the law would still be publicly accessible. I thank Chairman Issa and Congresswoman Ross for introducing this bipartisan legislation. It is a reasonable approach to a thorny problem in American law, and I regret that it has not been given the process that it deserves to ensure that it is the best possible product. I urge all members to support this legislation, and I yield back the balance of my time.